Hey guys, Christopher here. Wanted to show everybody today how to back up and restore a Sage 100 company. So the first thing you're going to need to do is access your database server, so your Sage 100 server, whether that's a workstation or a standalone server. You'll need to have administrative access, and you will open up your database administration software. Once it opens up, it's going to ask you to connect to your SQL Server, just like you would if you were opening the client software. You'll use the same username and password you would use as long as that user is a system administrator user. That's typically going to be someone who's an administrator for all companies, maybe some other user. We'll go ahead and click connect here because I am the administrator for this instance. And we're going to first back up a company. And then we'll restore that backup we create. So we're going to navigate to the tune-up, backup, restore, and then click backup companies. Here you'll see a list of all the companies on your Sage 100 menu. If you want to select multiple, you absolutely can. In this case, I only have the sample company on my demonstration instance. So we'll create the backup. If we wanted to save it somewhere other than the default on-demand backup location, we could browse here. We're going to use the default location in this instance. Once we click Create Backup, we'll be reminded that the default location only retains the backups for 30 days. This is to prevent overfilling or having outdated backups. If you save it somewhere else, you don't get this same message. And if you want to save it somewhere else for retention, for archives and things like that, it's absolutely an option for you. You'll see that message pop up for every company that you have checked if you're backing up to the default location. So once it completes each company, it would pop that message up again. Once it finishes backing up all of the selected companies, it will say backup complete. Once the backup's complete, you are ready to move forward with the rest of whatever process you need your backup for if you are only backing up. If you need to restore your company from backup, you can go ahead and come to the restore company from backup side. And in the restore as, leave it blank, but choose your browse option and click on demand to find our backups that we just created. We'll go ahead and open one of them. Here, if we were making a copy of our company for test purposes or anything like that, we could choose to restore it as a second company. You'll generally want to leave the upgrade company database to the latest version after restoration selected. This allows you to restore from backup and upgrade your database if you had backed up prior to a database upgrade and needed to restore due to some failure or other. Generally, you'll also set up a nightly maintenance and make sure to stagger that from your others. If you're not sure how to do that, keep an eye out on our channel for that video. We are going to go ahead and click Restore Company once we have our options set the way we want. It will take just a moment. All right, and once it says restoration of sample company is complete, your company has been restored. If we had chosen to restore it as the same name, we would have received a message that indicated we were going to overwrite the company. And when you're restoring, if you're intentionally restoring, you do want to say okay to that. As we can see, we now have two companies here in the list that we could back up. And so since we have two companies, if we open up the Sage 100 Contractor software, we should see, we'll connect, two companies on our menu, and we have restored a copy of the sample company to our menu. Once again, we could have used the same name here when we chose our backup. We could have just left the sample company and received a message that said it would overwrite, and we could have continued there. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Have a great day.